Okay, hi everyone, XXFaceman here, and today I'm going to be showing you my faction on the intox gaming Minecraft server. I'll be showing the IP in a pop-up text and in the description for you. So this is just going to be a tour of my faction here, so I'm going to turn around and we'll get started. Don't mind this. First of all, we have a pathway here. This took me about a couple hours to do because I had to bore through a tunnel. Keep in mind, everything here was built by me, except for one thing that I will show you at the very end. It's not complete, but it's not worth showing to the end anyways. So yeah, this is a 4x4 tunnel that goes not too long, almost at the very edge here. And I've been playing on the Minecraft intox server for about since December 2012, and there have been a few map resets, so I have lost some progress. And but what you'll just see here, that's what I'll show at the very end. This is an incomplete tunnel I'm still working on, and it is in the extreme hills biome, so I carve in the land. I don't just build around it or stuff like that. I carve into it. That's the sugarcane farm. I guess I'll start there. Actually, I'll show you the chicken farm first. Excuse the low FPS, all the chickens just kill it. There are a lot. I'm gonna soon make that bigger so it won't be as laggy. I'll actually show you the farm first. This farm contains wheat and carrots. It's semi-automatic. You just gotta hit the button right here. All the wheats come totally complete here. I'll show you how it works. I'm gonna just discard some of this cobble, and you'll see how it works. So I need more space. That should do. So you just hit that lever here, and then it just goes down just like that. Sorry for that interruption. Like I was saying, you just hit that lever, the water comes down, and I need to get my hoe because that one piece of oops, there it is right there. I had the whole time. Who knew? So yeah, just hit the levers and the water will open and close via a piston system right there. And just like this. Actually, I don't advise walking on the grass. I just advise going around it like this. And as you can see, one container gives you 43 wheat. And there are 7 paths for the wheat and 7 for the carrot. So you get a total of, oh, I don't know what the total is. I'll just post you another pop-up text on the video here. And so once I finish replanting, I will show you the rest of the faction, and we can continue on our path. The faction includes a chicken farm, horse farm, cow storage, and a 2 mob farms, and an enchantment room, and that's pretty much it so far. The nether portal you saw way over there is not the original nether portal, because the portal in the nether, if you walk into that one, it'll TP you to the one over there instead of our main one. I'm not sure why it does this. And we'll move on to the sugarcane farm here. As you can see, this is the sugarcane farm. There is it's nothing too big because you don't need it to be that big, because honestly we don't really We don't even harvest it at all. It's been sitting like that for a long time. Weeks probably without even being harvested. And this is our horse storage we have here. This was built by me, as stated earlier. We only have one horse because they are a bitch to find. They are so hard to find. And we do have saddles and armor for the horses. It's actually mine. I don't share. All these saddles were collected over the time of the map, and I have found this horse armor since the new update. So you saw that one iron set, 2 gold sets, and a diamond set. As you can see, I'm set, really. And this is really just right here. It's the pathway to nothing so far. And you can see these empty spaces here. There used to be glowstone there, but I replaced them into the floor, so I just need to fill those back up with iron bars. And to our right, we will see a cow farm. Nothing is up there so far, so we don't have to go up there. Just my storage with chests on grass, nothing important. And, yeah, nothing too important about the cows yet. We use the wheat to breed them, and I'm gonna be getting a pig farm soon.
Oh,
Once again, I apologize. It's very busy in my house, so let's continue with this tour here. I'll show you our storage, and there's the chicken leg once again. There's no on the server. There's no creeper grief, so it can't blow up in your face. And yes, here's that's really the bed. We don't even use it at all. This is storage. This is kind of a mixed chest. I don't know what's going in there for sure. These three are for dirt, but since we're low on dirt, I just put random stuff in there. And then these three are for cobble, and we're low on cobble because as you can see, I built the base out of stone brick, so I use it quite a lot. And this is like the building materials in a way. Like I keep like stuff for projects in progress. Like right now, I'm working on that unfinished tunnel, and all those materials in there will probably be used for that. So let's continue down here. We also have a netherwort farm. I didn't mention that. Netherwort farm yields a decent amount of netherwort. As in the update where you can grow netherwort in the overworld. I haven't put glowstone in yet, but that will be a mini project that will be completed when I have nothing else to do. And here's our zombie XP farm. We currently have two stations. I will AFK here for just until zombies pop up, and I'll show you where they come out. And the other one is just up those stairs, which is not actually that too far away. They should be popping out pretty soon, unless they already have. I will just wait here. Oh, there they go. Yeah. So you get about 3 to 5 zombies to spawn usually. And if we come over here where they pop out, I have to put glowstone down here too. It's all unfinished, and this is where we keep our armor. I enchanted these. I found them as garbage, so I didn't want them anymore. I will show you all the enchanted items we have. We have projectile protection 4, protection 2, grass protection 2, protection 2, aqua infinity 1, protection 2, projectile protection 3, feather falling 3, fire protection 2, respiration 2, protection 2, blast protection 2, projectile protection 2, and then blast protection 2. And then here we have our zombies. Oh, a villager. Oh, that's a shame because I have nothing to heal him with. So he's gonna die. Oh, what a shame. And yes, one hit kill. So yay for that. And it's that simple, really. Any of the drops that I get, I just put in here to be sorted or disposed of later. And I'll show you our second spot because that's important. This is our second one. It's very close. I'm very happy we got something this close to each other. And we don't have any drops in here yet. Oh, we do. Well, that shouldn't be in there, but it is. And those are in there because, oh, that was faster than the last one. This is just meant for other armor because the one in the bottom is getting pretty full. I'll just go wait to where I'm supposed to now. We drop from one hole. The lava behind is so I can dispose of anything I don't want. But that never really happens anyways. So they should be dropping pretty soon. They go up from where they spawn 20 blocks and they fall about 25, something like that. This one is a bit incomplete, so it does not do a one-hit kill. Sometimes, you'll see here. Sometimes it's not one-hit kill. It depends on the sword you have. I have sharpness 4, so most of the time it is. And no one else is coming? Nope. Okay, so that's our zombie storage farm. What? I gotta fix that later then. That's weird. I gotta fix that too. That random cobble, someone broke it and put cobblestone back in the way, which I do not like. I like stone brick, not cobble. So here we go. Also, shout out to XX Super Sonic Pigeon XX for actually getting me back into the recording business. He's currently doing a Let's Play on this server, and I will provide a link to his channel below. This is also our enchanting table. If you put a item in, it goes to a max of 30. And when you hit this lever, it changes it to high or low, and pistons go up, which block the spells from getting to the enchantment table. And then you have a low enchantment. So let's just take a look here and see what I get. Efficiency 1. Ooh, that's no, I'm impressed. And yes, we do have to walk through the nether portal because I thought it was a nice little spot-on fancy-smancy thing. This is just incomplete strip mining. This was abandoned months ago, but I did make a use for it down this tunnel over here. It's an obsidian farm, because I started to sell obsidian to the other players on this server. And what you're seeing here, all this used to be lava that I mined out to be obsidian. And I've probably gotten about 15 stacks of obsidian. Still being in the process of being mined. I saw that lapis, so don't freak out, I'll get that in a bit. And there's actually a lot more left. I've seen a lot more that is still to be mined. Let's see what we get here. Just the one? Oh, there's mine. There we go. 12. That's pretty good for two sections. And that is everything from our my tour. That's the whole faction that I know of, unless someone has built something hidden. Oh, that last thing I was gonna show you by those stairs. I almost forgot. We'll just walk up here. I could just do faction home, but really it's just at the top of the stairs, so there's no point. And, just leave a trail here for the next person to walk by, because they love that stuff. They just eat it up, in all reality. So what I'm showing you here is not built by me. Another faction member built this. That stone tower, you just saw a glimpse of it right there. Yep, top right corner of the screen. I play on short, and I record on short, because I am using a laptop, so not much very good FPS here. So as you can see, this is not complete. I will be carving up the land, as said before, and I'm not sure what he is doing with this. If I could show you more, I would. And I probably can go up with dirt to see what it looks like. Oh, I don't have dirt. I threw it away. Okay, I'll just use this then. So we'll just go up, take a peek at what we got, what he's doing over here. It's a good view. It's a great view of the faction, that's for sure. So just keep on going up. See what he's got going on. I like how it thins out, then goes up again, kind of like the that building in Toronto. Yeah, but except it doesn't get big again like this one does. So where's the top? Right there. Okay, that's the top of whatever this is going to be. So very nice. So that completes my faction tour. Thank you for watching, and be sure to watch out for any more videos I may post out, and I will see you all later. Goodbye.